Okay, good afternoon everyone. So in this class we'll start with objectives of construction management. Slides are visible now. Can anyone please? It's visible, right?
No, sir.
Yes. Okay. So, objectives of construction management. So, we'll be having different objectives. So, it is set by the construction management. They will be having certain goals so that as per their works, they are going to achieve those goals. So, in that first one, the main objective of this construction management is it should be properly planned and organized. So, here the main intention of construction management is it is going to plan a particular work in a such a way that it should start at a fixed date and it is going to end at a fixed date. Okay. So in between that particular schedule, so whatever the work will be there, so that work will be executing in a smooth way such that as per the client's requirements only, we are going to execute that within particular budget as well as the time requirement. Second one, the work should be executed as per the specifications. So here each and every work, I mean that entire project, whatever we have taken, so that project, it is going to be subdivided into the different activities. So those activities will be following certain specifications such that so and so work has to follow so and so code books, I mean the certain specifications, and then they should execute. For example, you can take the concrete work you have referred in fourth semester, that is you have used IS 10262 and then you have done the mixed design. The same as that thing, whenever you are going to work on a particular whenever you are going to execute a particular work, you need to refer the standard code books. So that one, it is fixed by the construction management, so that work whatever you are going to conduct, that one it will be with a 100% quality, and then the work should be completed within the specified time and estimated cost. So whatever you have, you will be doing the planning process, right? So in that planning, you'll be keeping few concepts in the mind such that the total cost as well as the duration part. So this construction management is going to be achieved those particular aspects such as the specified time and estimated cost. And the fourth one, the work should be properly supervised by the qualified and trained staff. So here construction management is going to pick a certain member such that they should be specialized in a certain category. I mean, they should be specialized in a particular branch so that they can execute that work in a better way. So here they are going to pick few members so that they should be well trained and they are much thorough with those execution concept. And so by doing this, we can complete the work within time as well as within the budget. And then the workmanship and quality of the work should be good. So here by referring the construction management, we can achieve 100% of the quality because the close supervision can be takes place in each and every activity of the project so that we can get 100% of the quality work. And here the work should be executed economically. Here the chances of wastages will be very less. I mean, we can say it as a 0% only until and unless we should get a certain hazards which are not predicted, such as this monsoons and all. So except those unpredicted situations, we can work out this particular management, I mean the project construction management, economically, so that whatever we have planned the total budget, within that only we can complete this work. Moving to the next concept, that is importance of construction management. So here, 1 minute. So importance of construction management, in that there are 4 points what we can see as the importance part of, I mean, the importance of this construction management in the current field. So first one is proper management that practices consistently will lead to a maximum production at least cost, because this construction management will be well planned with all the objectives, with all the activities of a project. And in that activities, they will be knowing for this particular activity, what and all we require, how much durations we require, how much quantity of the resources we require. So by considering those all requirements, this construction management will plan in a such a way that it can get the maximum output with the least cost. And a good construction management that results in a completion of a construction project within the stipulated budget. So here we'll be calculating, I mean, we'll be estimating each and every activities with the certain requirements. So here the chances of changes will be too less. For example, if we have planned to construct a particular wall, we'll be estimating each and everything, such as how many numbers of bricks are required, how much part of the mortar is required, and what about the cost of that. So each and everything will be estimating in that part, and then we'll be knowing the total budget part. Okay, so in this total budget we can complete this work. And then second one is the construction management that provides the importance for optimum utilization of the resources. So optimum utilization in the sense, how much it is required, only that much we need to use in the construction field. For example, for excavation you require so many different types of equipments. So if you have planned in a better way, you'll be knowing that this particular equipment on which date it is required and for how much time which is required. So as per your planned schedule, you'll be taking that particular equipment either for the rent or for after the purchase, but that usage of that particular equipment will be in a planned schedule. So that one you can get by using this construction management. So like that, other resources also you can consider with respect to time, machine, man, so many things, right? And in other words, it results in completion of a construction project with judicious use of available resources. So here in sometimes might be the availability of the resources which may get delayed. So that time the alternative plans will get preferred, so that in that meantime, how well we can utilize the remaining resources for other work. So that one also we can monitor by adopting this construction management. And third one is the construction management that provides necessary leadership and even motivates the employees to complete the difficult tasks well in time and extracts potential talents of its employees. So here, how well it can get motivate the employees means, so here they are going to give certain knowledge and different techniques so that the work should be get easier for the employees. And to get the benefits with respect to a time, they are going to give the motivation session to the employees, such that by that certain motivations even they can complete the work within time, and that directly proportional in the profit to the construction management concepts. And then here, this construction management which is going to pick certain potential talents by their certain works. For example, initially we will not be knowing that who is specialized in which field, right? So when you are going to give certain assignments or when you are going to give assign certain works for them, and after the end day, I mean end of that activity, how well he have managed that particular activity. So depends upon. Right, so like that, this construction management is going to pick certain talents based upon their specialization. And fourth one, the construction management, which is beneficial to society as the effective and efficient management of the construction that will avoid escalation of cost. So here, escalation is nothing but what? The increase in the demand part of the resources or else with respect to cost. Because in the planning stage, we'll be knowing that for this particular month, we require so much of money, right? So here, because of some issues such as the increase in the rate of the resources or the non-availability of the resources, that escalation may takes place. So that one, how well you can manage that one, you can study by adopting this construction management. So this construction management is going to help how well you can manage those things when that cost escalation will takes place in the project work. And not only the cost escalation of the cost, even time overrun, wastage of the resources, and unlawful exploitation, and then exploitation of the labor and the pollution of the environment. So which is going to concentrate on each and every field, not only with respect to cost as well as the time, even including the wastage of resources and the other aspects such as unlawful exploitation and then the pollution of the environment. So without harming any part of the environment, we need to start the work and we need to finish the work. So for that, the necessary precautions has taken care by this construction management. And then moving on to the next part, that is project organizations. So here are the different organizations you can see in the project. The most asked question, there are three different types of the organizations you can see here. First one is line organization, second one is line and staff, and third one is functional organization. So there are three different types of the organizations. How well it can be differed from each other, we'll see one by one. First one is the line organization. So here it is an organization where the responsibility is distributed from top to bottom in a triangular pattern, and which is also known as the military organization. So you can see one example here, that is line organization. So the work is going to divide from top to bottom management here, right? So top to bottom in a triangular portion. So I mean in a triangular section, because at the top only one person will be there. So he is going to divide that entire work into the different works, and depends upon that, the work is going to be divide as per the requirement. So here you can see one example in the figure, that is police headquarters, right? So that is a construction part. So for that, CE will be there, that is a chief engineer. So that chief engineer, he is going to divide the work in two parts, that is site engineer for works, site engineer for design. So here two different works will get divided. First one is with two different organization will get defined here. First one is site engineer with respect to works, and then site engineer with respect to the design. So here the works which is going to be executed as per the design concepts. So here this site engineer or that SE, even we can call it as a senior engineer also. So in this senior engineer part, the design, whatever it is done by the senior engineers, he is going to submit that one to the chief engineer, and then he will verify and distribute that work to the site engineer, senior engineer, which is belongs to a work department here, right? And next, that particular senior engineer, whatever the execution part will come for him, so he is going to divide that one, that work to the executive engineer and the deputed executive engineer. So as you can see in the hierarchy part. So like that, the work which is going to be divided from one person to the other person with a proper designations for them. Okay. And here it is generally used for the civil engineering constructions and which are not of every large magnitude. So here you can see it has been given in a triangular pattern so that no much divisions will be there, but as per the work schedules, as per the requirement of the work, we can divide that one into the number of sub organizations. Okay, this is line organization. And here you can see the merits, I mean the main advantages of this line organization. Is it audible, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, thank you. So here the merits of the organization, the first one, the command and control is very effective because the information, whatever it will get, passes from top management to the bottom management will be very clear. So so and so work has to be done, so that information is passed by the top management, the same thing which is going to be distributed to the respective sub organizations here. Okay. And responsibilities at all the levels are defined and fixed because once the work has been divided, so that particular sub organization head is going to be taking care of that particular work, so that whatever the responsibilities have been given, so it's their job to complete that one as per the requirement of chief engineer. Okay. And the system enables quick decisions to be taken at all the levels because a certain information has to be passed, so it should be come from the top management. So till to reach that to information to the bottom management might be, it may take some times, so that within that particular time, whatever the changes have planned or whatever the suggestions have been said, it should be taken care in a much well-defined time, so that informations or whatever the decision will be there, it should be very quick in all the levels. And each and individual carries out order of his next superior and thus helps in maintaining the rigid discipline. So here for every sub organizations a particular head will be there, so that members or those members have to be listened by his sub organization head, so that as per his suggestions they are going to carry out the work, so that we can say it as a system will be very rigid with a proper discipline. And the demerits of line organization, that is difficult to interchange of a work due to rigidity of the structures. So here already the work have been works have been divided with the different sub organizations, so that once they have passed those informations and once they will be having a required resources, if they want to change that from one sub organization to the other sub organizations, which is very difficult because already they will be planning whatever what and all work have to be done in so and so schedule part, so it is difficult to interchange from one part to the other part. So that is main disadvantage or demerits of this line organization. And communications are routed through a number of intermediate channels. So here you can see in the diagram, so the informations which is passed by this chief engineer has to be divided for senior engineers and then executive engineers, deputed executive engineers and assistant executive engineers, right? And at last assistant engineers. So like that, information has to be passed from so many channels, and once anywhere in between the junction the information has to pass clearly. If certain changes happens, so the same thing will be conveying to the remaining what we can see remaining the whatever the works we have assigned for those organizational members. So we need to be very thorough with the informations because once a small changes happens, the same thing it will be get followed by the people, those who are working under you, right? So that time, we need to be very clear with the informations which are passing from top management to the bottom management. And in line organization setup, the top executive has to take the decisions in respect of all the matters related to the project. So here, whatever the requirements are there, whatever the changes are there, whatever the rearrangement of the plans are there. So each and every decisions has to be taken care by the top executive only. So here, the intermediate management or the bottom management people have, those people don't have any rights to take the initiation in changing the plan and all. So whatever the information will be coming from the top management, the same thing will be executed in the current situation. And here the system is therefore not suitable for large project required specified services, because here the number of branches, I mean number of the sub organizations are less, then only we can prefer this, because a small changes has to be done, that time that information has to be passed from top management to the bottom management. So if it is not working out with a proper time, whatever the changes have been done, I mean whatever the planned changes are there, it is difficult to execute by the bottom management. So that is main disadvantage part of this line organization. And moving on to the next type of the organization, that is line and staff organization. So here, which is the one which will be having the benefits of line organization, such as rigidity in discipline and stability of the structure, and is retained, and the expert knowledge of the specialized is added to it. So there we have divided based upon their designations, right? For example, chief engineer will be there. We don't know that he belongs to which branch or in which field he is going to be much specialized. And those who are working under him, I mean, those who are working under chief engineer, so senior engineers will be there. So here in line and staff organization, for a particular work, a particular people have been assigned. For example, you can see here, this project manager, so those who are working with headquarters, so here that work have been divided according to their specialization. For example, here directorate will be there. So those who are specialized in the execution of the work, they have been divided. And then those who are specialized in the planning process, they have been made it as a separate. And then directorate with the stores and directorate with the accounts. So here they are working under a project manager, and as per his suggestions, they are going to taking care of the respective things there. So here again with the execution work, the different works will get divided, that is directorate works with respect to civil and directorate works with respect to mechanical. So here you will be knowing most of the civil engineer works with respect to execution part, and directorate works with respect to mechanical, that is comes under with the machinery part or equipment part which are used in the construction field. And directorate works with respect to electrical things, such as whatever the electrical connections are required for a particular construction work. So here, as per the specialization, that work have been divided. Okay, so in the first figure you can see here executive engineer, they have been specialized, but we don't know that he belongs to which category. I mean, he's in which field he is much specialized in his techniques. So overall, they have been nominated as per the designations, but in line and staff organization, they have been divided the work as per their particular specialization. And then here, merits of this line and staff organization, that is expert advice is available at all the levels, and maximum use of specialists are made. So here when we have divided the particular organization, or when we have assigned a particular work for the various sub organizations, they are specialized in its own techniques. So as per that only the top management people have been divided those works as per the different organizations which will be having different techniques. Okay, so here the people, those who are specialized in the execution part, are taken care by the civil engineering works, I mean directorate of the civil engineering works, and those who are specialized with the equipments part, and they are well trained with all the necessary usage of those equipments. And then those who are good at the electrical connections, they have been divided in various aspects. So like that, each and every part have been well divided such that the work have been properly divided so that works can be carried out easily. And here the operations are efficient, and hence the method economical in spite of additional expenditure on experts. So here sometimes when we have not followed this line and staff organizations, in between that we may feel some difficulties with respect to a certain expert. So again, with respect to a certain techniques. So again, we need to call some experts for the suggestion or for the advice, so that as per their suggestions, we need to carry out the further work wherever we have left. And here, the staff at site is competent to take the decisions, and hence work is not delayed. So here, as per their specializations only, the work have been divided so that they are free to take the necessary changes or decisions which are to be made in the execution part, so that work is not going to be delayed. Okay, because they are well specialized in its own field, so that they can take the necessary actions or whatever the changes are there, so that they can complete the work without any delay. Demerits are, if the duties of experts are not properly defined, there may be some misunderstandings between the staff and line workers. Here, we need to divide the work in a such a way that they should be perfect in those works. So small changes, for example, the electrical person can conduct the civil engineering works, and civil engineering work, person or expert can work in electrical. So there might be some changes. If it got occurs, then it is very difficult to get it back in a normal way, right? So here, when the experts are not specialized in their own talent, that time we may feel difficulty to execute the further work. And here the expert advice given by the specialist may be distorted by the time which is passed on the field worker. So these are the two demerits. And coming to the third one, that is functional organization. So here the line and staff organizations, which has suffers from one serious handicap in respect of confining the sphere of the work to the directly concerned channel. So here the group in charge tends to increase their authority regulating in partial disorganization of the system. So here functional organizations is like the combination of line and staff and line organization. And here whatever the in charges have been assigned, they tend to increase their authority. They will be having full authority to take the decisions on each and every activity. With respect to a requirement of the resources, with respect to a requirement of what necessary changes. So they are free to take that decisions in functional organizations. So in shortcomings of the line and staff organizations, which are taken care by the introducing a system of working as functional organizations. So they will be having certain specifications to execute the work. So by including that line and staff organizations, if we have added this functional organization, means that executing techniques have been clearly defined by these functional organizations by referring so many Indian standard code books as well as the specifications. And here you can see the salient features of functional organizations. They are strict adherence to the specifications, as I told. Whenever we are going to execute with the work, they are well defined with the Indian standard books. So that one, it is taken care by this functional organization. Second one, separation of planning and design part of the field work. So here work have been divided as design part as well as the planning part. So as per the planning only, the design has to be done, and as per the design concepts only, the execution part will take care. So this is monitored by the functional organizations. And here each individual maintains the functional efficiency, and the work is properly planned and distributed. The system is based on the knowledge of the experts, because so here the execution committee will be there. So they are going to suggest certain techniques in the part of execution. So this functional organizations is going to give certain clear idea that how well we can conduct this work, how well we can manage this particular work. So step by step they are going to explain, and then according to that we can carry out the work so that we can complete the time as per the time schedules and as per the budgeted cost. Okay, so here some of the defects you can see. Sometimes the functions overlaps, which may give rise to misunderstanding small functions. So here misunderstanding may take place because it is interconnected with all other departments. So a certain mistakes found or any overlap comes, which is difficult to track that from which department this problem has been occurred. So that is main the defect of this functional organization. And the responsibility which cannot be fixed directly on any individual, and sometime a worker may not know who is his immediate senior head. So because this is like a closed loop, we don't know that under whom we are working. So might be we need to hear the suggestions from even from the construction engineer and even from chief project manager. So we don't get the proper information from the top management. So that time which is difficult to execute the work when we don't have a proper channel to reach the information from top management to the bottom management. So here the main role of construction project management is, first one is to avoid the delay process and to achieve economy in project cost, and to use the resources economically. Okay, so these are the main roles of this construction project management. So when you have adopted a certain concepts or the theory which are defined by this construction project management, so then you can achieve these concepts, that is avoiding of delay. I mean, with respect to a time, we can complete the work as per the planned schedule, and to achieve the economy in project cost, because each and every process have been well planned so that there is no delay in the construction work, that directly proportional in the saving of cost. And third one is to use the resources economically. Here construction project management, which is going to divide the work with the different activities, and then those particular activities are required in certain resources. So each and everything will be predefined so that as per the planned schedule only they are going to use the resources at the right time at the right place, so that obviously the system or entire project will comes under in good economical condition. Okay, so today we'll stop here. So if you're having any doubts, you can clear it. Yes, all are there? It's audible, right? Or simply we start. Yes. If you're having any doubts, you can ask. Else place your attendance and you can disconnect the call. Okay. Deepesh?
Yes, sir.
Yes, functional organization, right? So here you can see the functional organizations, here it will be knowing like how well we can execute the works. So there we have divided the work in two different organizations, that is in line organization and line and staff organization. So line organization is nothing but a proper channel will be there with respect to a designation, right? And here line and staff in the sense a certain technical people will be there with respect to those designations. And here functional organization in the sense by adding this line as well as the line and staff organization, which is going to give the clear idea about how well we can execute that. So here only by referring certain specifications, this works whatever which is assigned by the chief engineer, no? So that one it can be executed by referring this functional organization, right? So it's like a supportive organizations for those about to. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Any other thing, Deepesh?
No, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes, yes, fine. Place your attendance and then, yes.